Hi, I'm Puya Dianat, host of the Next Mile podcast. I started this podcast because my wife, coworkers, and friends kept rolling their eyes every time I started to geek out about transportation. I mean, think about it. At least I do. Every second of every day. How can I not? The world is constantly moving around us. Scooters, cars, planes, bikes, buses, trains. Everybody is going somewhere, doing something. A few weeks before I decided to do this podcast, I had been in an accident. I was driving home with my son, Jack. He's 3.5 years old, so he was asking like 58 questions in the back seat, and I was paying attention to him. Out of nowhere, we're going through an intersection, and someone from the right lane decides to take a left turn directly into my car. At that moment, I was able to perfectly react and get around at least the worst part of that accident. They ended up hitting my front fender, and my 2009 Honda Fit, which I oily drove, was it met its end. It forced me to look at everything I did a little bit differently, and I'm glad it did. My wife, Mallory, she was, I think, 8 months pregnant at this point. I sprung on her that, hey, I know this is not the best time, but we have two cars as a family. Why not just give one up? Why not let me try to figure out what I think our neighborhood should look like for me who has to travel 2.3 miles a day? She very begrudgingly agreed, and I surprised her by asking that. I had set up a podcast station at the studio. I wanted to just record her natural reaction to us having a conversation about this.
Absolutely not.
No.
We are not shaking hands. I need to call your mom.
Not on board.
Are you kidding me?
And your wife thinks you're crazy.
I wasn't living the life that I envisioned being the best version that it could be. There's obviously a lot that she's going to have to help me figure out as we drop a car, which is a very real problem in America. It had disconnected our lives in a weird way. I would not have been able to take that first step without involving her in the conversation. And she has a more pragmatic look at these things. And I wanted to almost use her as a barometer of, what do you think about this? What do you think about the world that we've created that is defined by what cars need and parking lots and inefficient ways of moving around? And it's not just a scooter, it's not just a train. How is this whole thing sort of messing up all of the good things that we've created as a species? There's no more interesting microcosm than to try to use a normal American family like ours, which is anything but normal, to answer that question. And I wanted her to be down for the journey. For me, family's important, so I had to make that part of the conversation. So once we started the great experiment of going to a one-car family and I was moving around in a lot of different ways, I realized I was a lot happier really quickly. First of all, sometimes I had great conversations in shared lifts. I saw other parts of my community. I had a very specific way that I got home. And just the experience of using these new technologies of ride sharing, electric scooters, electric bikes that I can check out with my phone instantly changed my life, and it made me happier. I wanted to explore this more. I knew that there's these emerging areas of technological growth. I've called them the five A's. That's alternative energies, augmented reality, artificial intelligence, adaptive systems, and autonomous assistance. All of those things have sort of come together at this exact moment in our history. I had an opportunity to explore that in a very real way. I'm next to Georgia Tech, and there's a lot of really smart people there. We have the third worst traffic in the world as a city in Atlanta. The world's busiest airport is here. And the state of Georgia is also like a microcosm of America. It's a big red rural area with a densely populated blue core. I'm in the perfect place to talk with people about what travel should look like. how should they be part of this conversation? What are they doing? And why aren't normal people more interested in talking about it? And I knew that all of those amazing things are happening to take advantage of those, the growth in those technological areas I mentioned. And I wanted to bring those ideas in a continuous, constant way to an audience that maybe doesn't normally ask themselves, what would my life look like without a car? What would our world look like if you could move around it in 80 minutes? What would our city look like? What would my neighborhood look like? How could our lives be better if we take this one area that has made us connected and great, transportation? How do we take that, take these new technological advancements, and completely redefine a happier existence? This podcast explores the future of transportation, on the ground and across the skies. How will we travel in the future? Let's take this far and wide, but let's start with the next mile.